Welcome back. Here we are again for the third video in this short series. There's more videos to come on porting. Now, for those who watched the second video but didn't watch the first video, you might be wondering, why didn't we do the transfers and the inlet, and why didn't we section them up and do a specific time area analysis? Well, if you watched the first video, you would have found out all the reasons as to why, and why we are just doing the exhaust port at the moment. If you want to know what we're doing and why we're doing what we're doing in this video, go to the first and second videos in the series. See the link at the top right hand corner of your screen. We're back to the expansion chamber software and the measurements that we took in the second video from the exhaust port. We'll put into the port diameter, port length, and port flange diameter. So the port diameter, P, is the cylinder end of the port, the curved port window at the piston end. The port length we've also measured, and the port flange diameter is the outlet of the exhaust port where the exhaust pipe header bolts onto the flat flange. So, as you'll see in the software, these are all diameters, and diameters are round. So what we've got to do is we've got to convert our measurements from the traces that we took off the exhaust port at both ends, and we've got to convert those into an area value, and then convert the area value into a diameter value. Now, the reason we do that is because the expansion chamber itself has round diameters in the expansion chamber. And the diameters in the expansion chamber, as I've explained in previous videos, bear a direct relationship by way of the equations used. And these equations are Gordon Blair's equations for the three-stage diffuser expansion chamber. Those diameters of each section are relevant to, or are a function of, the diameter of the port. So that's why we have to convert the area of a port into a diameter. Now, that's only for the purposes of the expansion chamber and not the purposes of porting in general, but that is explained in the first video. So that's why I'll point you back to that rather than just going over and expounding on the same thing again. It's a short video, painless to watch. So the first thing we need to do is we need to take our measurements and convert them. So we will go to the tools in here. You can't see this on the screen, and we'll open the port calculations window. Here we are in the exhaust port area diameter calculator, and we'll take those measurements that I've got in the second video, the previous video, and we will put them in. Now, curved port width is as I alluded to in the second video, the previous video. This is the port as traced onto the piece of paper that is curved inside the cylinder. Now that has to be converted to a chordal width, which is a measurement directly across the port in a straight line, or in the straight line of a, if we placed a chord across it, so to speak. So, as I said in the second video, we can use the calipers to just measure that straight across, but then it's a little bit more accurate if we do it mathematically. So the curved port width that we actually took is 25.5 millimeters. The second component we need to that is the bore size, and the bore size of this engine is 44 millimeters, which we measured in the previous video. So now we'll calculate the actual direct line width across, hit the calc width. So the port width directly across from one side of the wall to the other is 24.1 millimeters. The port height, which is the total height from the very bottom all the way to the very top, okay, including the curved segment area. Again, go back to the previous video, all explained in that one. Our port height measured in the previous video was 12.5 millimeters. We had two corner radii. As you can see, this has three, four, or one. So we had two of the same radii for the bottom corners. And we measured those in the previous video. Port radius, 4.5 millimeters aside. So we just had two of those, so they're the same. As to why this has got a different type, that's explained in an earlier video that covers this this new version 1.10 of the software. You can go back and refer to that if you're not sure. Corner radius. The next one is the segment, and the segment is the refers to the curved segment. So what we did is we drew a line straight across there in the previous video, and we measured the segment height, and the segment height itself was 3 millimeters. And the radius we used by measuring that base of the ear filter. Yes. Segment radius was 28.5 millimeters. If you want to know what this little window is for, go back to the video that covers the update of 1.10 version of the software, and that I explain that. We've got all our values in there. We hit calculate area. So the area of the port is 271.73 millimeters squared, and that calculates, it automatically does that. If you know the area of the port, you can just put the area in there and hit area to diameter, and it'll give you the diameter. So the diameter is 18.6. So basically, we'll just write down our diameter for the port at the piston end is 18.6 millimeters. And now we're back to do the other end of the port. And the other end of the port has the flat flange. And so we can take a direct measurement because it's not curved, it doesn't have the cylinder. We don't have to go through this process. We can just put the direct straight across the port width, input it directly. And I didn't show you the measurements of that in the previous one, so I've taken the time to do that. Our total width of the port there was 26.5 millimeters straight across. The port height out at the flange was 18 millimeters. The radii of the corners, bottom two corners, was the same as the other end at 4.5. The segment or the curved part of the port out at the flange end, the segment height was 2.3 millimeters. I measured. The segment radius is 44.75 millimeters. So that's how we do the flange end. We don't have to worry about this because we've already got our straight across width. Calculate the port area, 451.02 millimeters squared. Now all these numbers are rounded off to the two decimal places, which is close enough. So 23.96 is the diameter. So I'll write down the 23.96. You don't have to write them down because when you're in the software, you can just go back to the main window and put it directly in the main window. But I can't do it with this screen capture software, so well, let's go back to the main window because we're done here. So here we are back at the main window of the 2T Exhaust Calc software. So if you refer back to the video previously done measuring the exhaust port timing with the degree wheel in the thumbnail, you'll see that we measured a value of 154 degrees. This engine, this 49cc engine, peaks at 7,000 RPM. And the exhaust port temperature, well, it's an extremely low output engine, so it's about 300 degrees Celsius, I calculated earlier. Now we take our diameter values that we got in the previous port calculation window from our measurements that we took in the previous video, 18.6. The port length, as I measured in the previous video, was 24 millimeters. The flange end of the area one, which I have calculated now, is 23.96. That's 23.96. And now, okay, so we've got those values in there. Now, I won't mess too much with these values, okay? These are explained in other videos. This one should probably be a little bit larger because it's a low BMEP. Whatever. All right, so we'll hit the calc button. And as you can see, there's the tuned length. That is from P to D6. Again, I've covered that in the software how-to videos, so I won't go into too much about that. This is mainly to focus on how to calculate the area and ports and put those in the diameters there. But this one, as you can see, the flange diameter is bigger than the entry to the diffuser cone. Not good. Can't have that. So what we can do is we can increase that. Go a little bit above the Gordon Blair amounts. Let's just go 2.9. There we go. Yeah. So 1.29. 23.96. 23.99 at D1. So D1's a little bit larger than F. But I mean, you know, if we just went straight header, then that would mean straight header. You know, same size flange in there. Just that the D1 has always got to be the same size or larger than the flange size, because that port does expand out a little bit, the difference between the cylinder end and the flange end. So the main thrust of it is that's how to put the area and port diameters in, because we're, you know, porting is what we're talking about, not necessarily the software. You can go and mess around with the software and change stuff like that around if you want to, you know. Boom. Whatever. So that covers the porting with respect to tracing the exhaust port, measuring the total area, converting it to diameters, just for the purpose of actually putting it into the software to calculate the expansion chambers. But as I said in the first video, the actual tracing of all of the ports in port mapping is for a separate process, and that is where we calculate our time area targets for all of our ports, including our blowdown, specific to the engine configuration and the purpose we're going to use the engine for, the characteristics we want from it. Once we've done the time area targets and specific time area analysis, so you know how big the ports should be and how big they should all be in relationship to one another, then the next subject after that will be actually the shape of the ports and issues to do with the flow in the ports. And we're going to sort of go right down the rabbit hole there. But that is for later videos, and that will do it for today. So I hope you all enjoy your Easter. Bye for now.